I consider myself a tribute to the King of Rock and Roll.
The King. Paul Butler is taking care of business by teaching Tots the laws of Elvis.
And remember, always be good to your mama.
That's next. You're probably as tired of Elvis impersonators as we are, but Paul Butler isn't a copycat. He's an original, a bus driver who thinks kids should learn more on their way to school than just dirty jokes. George Ciccarone took a ride with the King of the Road.
Another morning in Anderson, Indiana. But for the kids who hop aboard this bus, the day begins with a little Elvis 101.
Are y'all ready to go to school?
Yeah!
We're just about ready to take you.
His name is Paul Butler, mild-mannered school bus driver. But about 2 days a week, he straps on his outfit for a lesson in elementary Elvis.
We're heading out.
The whole idea is to just keep the memory of the man Elvis, and it's to make the kids happy, to give them a smile, give them something to laugh about, and give them something to talk about. I feel like if I can make them smile, then I've done my good deed for the day.
I bet you make them smile.
Oh, yeah.
Like so many other Elvis impersonators around the country, about 20 years ago, he says he was called upon by a mystical force to dedicate a portion of his life to the King. Now in Anderson, anyways, he is the King of the Road. Along his stop, forget about the Ninja Turtles, never mind the new kids on the block. It's perfectly predictable that these little people prefer Presley.
Give me five. Thank you, baby.
Well, you're probably wondering how this whole thing started, right? Well, one Halloween about 15 years ago, All for Charity decided to do a grave impersonation of the King.
Now, let's face it, most of these kids don't have the slightest idea who Elvis Presley was, and that's just what gets Paul all riled up, providing the inspiration for him to dress up and teach these kids something more than just their ABCs, but also their E's.
When you see the little young smile, it's really overwhelming.
Y'all remember to be good in school today? Have a good day. And remember, always be good to your mama. See you, youngins. Y'all be good. We'll see you, youngins.
Come home, my child. Kiss me, my darling.
In case the subject of Elvis ever comes up, and you know it will, you tell him that Elvis is alive and well and driving a school bus in Anderson, Indiana.
Thank you very much.
I love it.
Although rock and roll legend Elvis Presley died nearly 15 years ago, alleged sightings of the King keep cropping up, which seem to contradict this fact. Against our better judgment, we sent out producer Todd Gould to explore Elvis sightings in Anderson, Indiana. Oh, man. You won't believe this.
The real story behind the events that shocked the world. The Elvis Files.
We think that by the end of our program, you too will be able to hold two opposing ideas in your mind. First, that Elvis Presley passed away in 1977. And secondly, that he still may be alive.
Yes, whether spotted enjoying a big gulp at a nearby 7-Eleven, or working in the produce aisle of a West Palm Beach supermarket, Americans seem to have a strange fascination with the late great King of Rock and Roll, Elvis Presley. Whether we believe in the bizarre rumors of Elvis's, shall we say, strange reappearances, none of us can escape the eerie curiosity which stares at us in the banner headlines of offbeat tabloids draped across the checkout aisles.
Now, we here at Across Indiana pride ourselves in trekking across this great Hoosier heartland in search of the special or unique or even bizarre. But when I suggested tracking down Elvis sightings in the state of Indiana, well, even our producers gave a few raised eyebrows. Nonetheless, here we are in Anderson, Indiana, and we're going to take you on a very special quest, the search for Elvis Presley.
as throughout the Hoosier State, one would not be surprised to see one of these big yellow babies rolling down the road, taking kids to and from school. But on one particular route, there's a bus driver who has the good citizens of Anderson all shook up.
I'm all shook up. Mm-hmm. When I wear the full attire, it puts off a good image to them, and they get all excited about it, and everybody looks, and everybody's talking, and everybody's staring.
Meet Paul Butler, bus driver, Elvis impersonator.
I'm all shook up.
Mm-hmm. My mother bought me an album, and it was Elvis' Golden Records, and I liked it because all the Golden Records aren't with his faces in it. I didn't know nothing about him, and my mother said, I'll buy the album for you, but you got to memorize every song on that album. Our family was a music family. We played music every weekend, so it was just natural to memorize the words to the songs. And through the years, my voice just kept turning more and more like his. And from one record to another, I just kept liking him more and more.
Paul Butler began his career impersonating Elvis as a wiry 13-year-old, armed only with fake sideburns and a pair of blue suede shoes. As a nightclub performer, Paul has portrayed his idol for over 18 years. And while his unique relationship with Elvis may be an intriguing story in and of itself, Paul's story goes even further, from the unusual to the extra special.
Most school bus drivers, when you ask a student about their school bus driver, they call them a crab apple, you know, or an old grouch, you know, this or that. You know, you ask my kids about me, they're going to come back with a great response because we always have a good time.
Paul sees himself simply as a big kid, taking a fun and unusual approach to the daily grind. But to his young charges, he is something much more. To them, in the immortal words of country singer Roger Miller, Paul is truly the king of the road.
Trailer for sale or rent, room to let the distance. No phone, no pool, no pet. Ain't got no cigarette, but 2 hours of push and broom by the 8x12 4-bit room. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road.
How about we go sing a little song?
Yeah!
Okay, on my account, in on the bus I'm gone, a crying all time. In on the bus I'm gone, a crying all time. You ain't never called Robin, you ain't no friend of mine. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, a crying all the time.
Now, whether Paul's young fans are touched with a strange type of burning love for Elvis's music doesn't really matter to Paul. What does matter is the special philosophy he continually presents to them.
The message that I try to give the kids is that there was a man who did care, cared a lot about kids and the individual and the world itself. Always keep a smile on their face. They're going to get through life a lot easier than a lot of the other kids that doesn't have this philosophy.
We're caught in a trap. I can't walk out.
Now, to this suspicious mind, I had to wonder, what was Paul Butler's favorite Elvis song?
My favorite Elvis.
Certainly is doing it his own special way, starting off children's days with smiles on their faces and songs in their hearts. And while this earth may only know one Elvis Presley, the world could certainly welcome many more Paul Butler.
The greatest thing about being a school bus driver is these little kids watching them from this high, and now they're this high looking at me. You know, 7 years these kids have grown up, I mean, and they're coming up to me going, hey, I remember you, you know, and you really were nice to me, and I'll never forget it. And the little kids, they come running up to me and hug me when they see me. So, you know, there's nothing. No amount of money or nothing in the world that could replace that, you know. If I died tonight, I couldn't complain. You know, I've lived a great life. I've done some things that nobody's ever done before, and people would just love to do. So I can't complain. And that's what proves to me that the philosophy is true, you know. If you want something, you got to give a little. And if you give, you will receive. And that's what the magic word does.
But not too big around. I'm a man of means by no means,
way down where holy woods, way down where I never could, way down, 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 way
down. Oh, how you doing?
Room to let it in. No phone, no pool, no pet. Ain't got no cigarette, but 2 hours of pushing broom buys a 8 for 12 for bed room. Mama, man of means by no means, king of the road.
I consider myself a tribute to the king of rock and roll.
At MCL, the desserts alone are enough to bring most people back.
Oh, man.
MCL, it cooks. Need some fresh ideas for dinner? Brought to you by the only people who tip at MCL, the employees. MCL, it cooks.